Hello. Okay, so first of all, I have a new phone, so apologies if I'm actually looking at myself because the lens is there. And this is still kind of confusing me a little bit. So first of all, it's been a while since I last did a vloggy kind of thing. I think it was HorrorCon last, so it was only vlog number 2, so I've really been slacking. But I wanted to do something a little bit different. I am going to do another photo shoot vlog relatively soon. It's just that I just haven't done many shoots recently, so it's just something I've not really factored into just yet. But I'm going to do something a little bit different today. It's vlog number 3, and they've all been different so far, so I don't know why I'm saying that. But as you can see, I am in the shed. Now, the shed is a relatively new acquisition. It's come with the house that I've been in for about a year, and I must have reached an age where having a shed has, you know, improved my life immeasurably, because I now have somewhere to store all the crap, which also includes the bones and skulls and random bits of dead animal that I have, which I crystallise. You may have seen some of the photos that I've posted on social media recently. Some of those projects are well over a year and a half old, and there've been things that I've just been messing around with various chemical solutions that you can buy on, Amazon or eBay. They're all very safe. I mean, this is one that I bought, and just see that crystal growing kit for children. Just random salts and chemicals in there. Doesn't really do an awful lot. Nothing poisonous. So these things are all fairly safe to use and whatnot. They usually come in little things like this, little measuring parts. You can see they're still. It's an irritant. I'm an irritant. But violet amethyst crystal growing compound. And they just come with a few little bits and pieces. They dissolve in hot water. I might take you through the process because I might mess around with some stuff in a minute. But the end result is something like what I've been posting on Instagram and whatnot. And I've also painted them. I've also got little other bits and pieces, such as some copper, isn't it? Copper foil and white satin spray paint. I've also used black lacquer spray paint, which I think gave a very cool effect. But here are some of them. So as you can see, a lot of purple ones so far. Very proud of the skull. It is incredibly delicate though, because these are ethically sourced, which means that they have just been found in fields, and I've bought them on eBay as such, or people have donated things to me. So for example, my friend Liv, she's donated some horns that have, it used to be used in headdresses, but now all her headdresses are 100% vegan. So, as we can see, there's a few different. Oh, there's some ram's horns here that are massive, brilliant. So I don't know how those will actually work as something to crystallize, because they're slightly different to the old bone. But I say I've still got some. There's another sheep's skull and sheep's jaws and various little bits and pieces. This is just something I like to experiment with and just see how they turn out. But yeah, it's something. It's just a bit weird. I think I first saw something like this online a couple of years ago, and I thought, that's interesting. I think there were human skeletons or something that had been found in a cave in South America, and they just look phenomenal. I thought, well, that'd be interesting to use just random bits of skull and bone and just see what happens with them, just using normal kits and mineralize them, crystallise them. So, yeah, that's what I've been doing. I've really been slacking. I've only really had three experiments on the go, the ones that I have posted online, but I'm going to try and do a few more. I've got some bones as well that still need cleaning. So I think there's a big skull kicking around here somewhere that still needs a good clean. That's a kind of disgusting process. I won't bore you with that. If you're really interested, you can find that kind of stuff on YouTube. But yeah, it's a bit grim. But like I say, most of this stuff comes from field walking, so it is usually just kind of dirt and other bits and pieces that are in there. But anyway, I'm gonna get one on the go at the moment, and just see what comes along. See what chemicals I've got. I've got some Rama quartz. No idea what that is. Natural geodes, chemical, aluminium, potassium, sulfate. So that's something nice and interesting. Orange geode. I'm not sure about the orange. Golden citrine. I'm not sure about gold. Geode shell plasters. What else we got in here? Have we got any more purple? I like the purple. Pink quartz. That could be cool. Not very goth, but pink quartz. Aquamarine blue. There's one. That might do for something. And frosty diamond. Frosty diamond might be good. But what else is in here? Emerald green. I tried emerald green on one thing, and it went, well, let's say it went mouldy. It wasn't great. But ultimately, I managed to rescue that one and turn it into something a bit more interesting. But yeah, I think these things are mainly food dye with other bits and pieces as well. So they're not chemically too intense. So you can just mess around with them. Usually these kits come with some absolute terrible plasticky things in them. And yeah, see, green food dye I tried didn't work. So I probably won't be using that one again. But yeah, all the little bits and pieces, they usually, here's the pipette that I used on the purple. So it's the end of it. I don't know if you can see that. It's just crystallized itself. I don't know if that one will be any good or whether I need to. Oh no, that's all crumbled away. That's fine. So I'm going to do something. I'm going to try it. And this is already 8 minutes of me rambling, so I'm probably going to cut this down as well. But yeah, I'm going to see what happens. I might try some of the horns and see what happens with those. But yeah, so solution, hot water, put it somewhere warm. Basically, and what I will do is I will come back and I will show updates as well. So hopefully we'll get some nice crystal growth on a couple of horns or something like that, and we'll see what happens. Okay, so I'm in the kitchen now. Just boiled the kettle because hot water is kind of essential to this. Right, there's always a degree of experimentation with this. I'm completely winging it. I mean, my GCSE chemistry is long in the past, and all I know is that you need to just dissolve these and kind of give them these solutions and kind of give them something to latch onto. So I've kind of collected some powder from the inside of this Pyrex mixing bowl. For some reason, it seems to help it. I mean, it is essentially, it's just solution that's gone through the mill a couple of times. So, yeah, it is just kind of crystals and stuff. So that's, what I'm going to be using, again, just a normal Pyrex mixing bowl. I'm opting for this time the aquamarine blue, because everything so far I've done has tended to be purple or blue, apart from one thing when I began, and that was red, and it soon became pink, which I wasn't a fan of, and it's now got more crystals on it anyway, which are white, and it's been in the sun, it's kind of bleached. But yeah, so what I'm going to try and do is fit several of these things in the bowl. So I've got another sheep's jaw here, which is
missing a couple of teeth, but otherwise it's a pretty, you know, it's not bleached white or anything, but it kind of doesn't matter. There's a couple of horns here, which are, you can see they've just been shed at some point, so, you know. And a couple of antlers, they've come off something at some point. Yeah, again, you know, I don't know whereabouts these have come from, but, you know, these were just gifted to me. But I want to make good use of them. So I'm going to try and fit these into here. And I'm going to try and dissolve some of this solution as a base, which will give it a kind of purple thing. And I'm going to kind of sprinkle this on top and then add some water on top of this to kind of stimulate the growth. So I will show you what I mean in a minute, but I'm going to have to put the camera down now to kind of do this. Okay, so I pretty much just dissolved what was in here, some of it straight into the dish, which I then used the pipette just to kind of soak all the horns and the bones. The rest I dissolved and just kind of poured straight over. As you can see, there's kind of like a nice metallic tinge, which is kind of cool. And this stuff I've used sparingly. You can see I've not used much of that. I could have dissolved that as well, but I already had a fair bit, so... I'm just going to use that quite sparingly and see how that goes. So as you can see, there's a really nice kind of blue and purple tinge to everything so far. What I will do is over the next few days, I will revisit this. I'll keep it somewhere warm, covered in a towel or something. And yeah, I'll just kind of keep revisiting it. I might dissolve some more of the blue stuff and put that over it. I'll add more crystals and we'll just see, kind of see what grows, if anything. If not, then they'll just be interestingly stained horns, which isn't a bad thing. These will also just move, I'll move them about gradually and just try and get everything covered without disturbing too much of the crystal growth, which is harder than it sounds. But yeah, I will update you on those as we go along, and I'll turn this into one long video, and hopefully the final results I will get, I'll get to photograph at some point, and yeah. So hopefully that's been interesting. I don't know whether this is anything that anybody is ever going to be really too bothered about learning, but it's something that interests me, and you know, I just thought I'd share it. I've kind of really enjoyed doing the photographs, and it's a kind of interesting different project for me because I use digital cameras and lots of digital media and videos and things to sort of do my artwork through. So things like painting and you know, making the crystal skulls and horns and things, it just does something a little bit different, a little bit more of a distraction, a bit more tactile, I suppose. So yeah, I will keep you updated on these, and hopefully there'll be some cool photographs of them at the end. And like I say, if anybody wants these at any point, you know, feel free to ask. Okay, so these have been sat in the bowl for about a week now. As you can see, all the liquid has evaporated. It's been in the airing cupboard, so it's been nice and warm, so all the liquid's evaporated, and it's left behind some rather interesting colours. We've got some whites, we've got some blues, we've got some purples, but as you can see, that most of it is... it's got a pretty good coverage, but most of the interesting stuff's happening on the top there. So what I'm going to do is give these another pass with the blue solution. So as you remember last time, I just added a few sprinkles of this towards the end. What I'm going to do is dissolve some of this in some hot water and put it in there, give it another pass for another week, move things about, and then just see what else happens. So, yeah, okay, so that's update number one, and hopefully there'll be update number two rather soon, and they'll look a bit different. Right then, so
This is just a quick update. It's actually been a really long time since I last shot the other parts of this video. I think that was during the summer, and it's now a couple of days before Halloween, but I just thought I'd show you the results of those experiments finally. So here's the jaw that we did. So if I put it in here, I'll give you a closer look. So as you can see, it's quite well oxidized, but there's a fair bit of blue has taken to it as well, so it's looking pretty good. It looks really kind of freaky and calcified and stuff, but that's in there with the rest of the bones at the moment that I quite enjoy. So I'll probably do a proper photo of that at some point. The horns, on the other hand, I'm not too sure. You can see there is some colouring. Crystals haven't really taken as well. I don't know whether that's because they're horn rather than bone. Maybe they're less porous or something like that. I don't know. So there's a few on there. Not amazing. I mean, I could always reboil these and start again from scratch, because I think what's on those are maybe a little bit too brittle, a little bit too messy looking. But, well, that's the name of the game, though. It's all about, I mean, that one's not too bad. But yeah, they've not been varnished properly or anything. They've just had a quick going over just to seal them off and stop any mould occurring. But that's about as good as these have gone. So I don't know. I think what I might do with the others is spray paint them and add metallic elements to them and things like that. So I've still got a big... I've still got a really big bag, so it's not like these are the be-all and end-all. I've got loads in here, so plenty of more to do things with. But yeah, I think definitely the process takes better with bones than it seems to do with horn. So I don't know whether that's something to keep in mind moving forward. But yeah, I'm going to mount that and these into some frames with some other elements at some point when I can find some. This is definitely going to go into a specimen jar when I can get hold of one, and I will make those for sale. I think I'll sell them because they are pretty cool. I do enjoy how they've come out, but yeah, they are quite delicate, as you can see, the sort of the porous elements and things. But there's another load of bones in there, and there's another skull in that thing, so there's still plenty more to be getting on with, so there's still a lot to do. But other than that, that's how those have come out, so I hope you enjoyed that. And yeah, so that's just a really overdue vlog on what I've been doing with these things. But I'll post some of the pictures of these ones that came out really nicely, so you can see them more in all their glory. But yeah, keep an eye out. There's more coming up on the channel. We've got a couple of new short films and some test footage coming as well. So in fact, those might already be up by the time I finish editing this. So do check those out, and thanks for watching.